Christian convert. You are an ex-Christian, but had you converted from Islam to any other religion, does the Quran not say that you should be stoned to death? How can you possibly defend a faith that you cannot leave on the basis of peace?
Interesting question. Well, basically, in terms of myself now, if I left Islam and went to Christianity, I wouldn't be stoned to death, I wouldn't be executed and so on. The laws for this, not the rule for apostasy, the law of apostasy, this is actually should be called the law of treason, and it only is operative in a state for the protection of the community of a state against people who are rebellious against the state and so on. That's the context. It's not it's been a mistranslated. And you know why it's been mistranslated? Because the Christians implemented a law of apostasy based on the Old Testament teaching, which still has the moral law, whereby they execute the apostates. This was practiced for 100 years. John Calvin, great Christian scholar, executed Michael Servetus for apostatizing from belief of the Trinity. And so on. So this is only related to the issue of, from the Islamic perspective, treason against the state, against the community, not against just simply leaving your faith. And again, this is the West, who is still traumatized by its Christian past, looks at Islam through the lens, expecting to see the same kind of Christian, old medieval Christian thinking in Islam, and hence they interpret it deliberately in that manner. Now, there are many hadiths about the issue of apostasy. Every hadith, bar one, has always been towards a person who's been rebellious or tried to undermine the Islamic community and state of Muslims, try to attack it or get people to attack it. And the only one hadith where one person just wanted to leave Islam or leave doing the salah, the prayers and the zakat and so on, the Prophet Muhammad exiled him, just said, okay, you're fine, you know, I'm not going to let you, I'm not going to rescind my pledge that you've given me, that you're going to give salah to God and zakat to charity. So this Bedouin guy in a huff storms out of Medina, doesn't want to come back. This person has apostatized from Islam. So 1 minute. This person apostatized from Islam, and the Prophet Muhammad didn't say, right, we must kill this person because he wants to rescind doing the salah and paying the zakat. He just left. Just one guy just left, and he didn't want to come back. Because the Prophet Muhammad would not take back his pledge, which he made to God, and so on. So this is the one hadith where it was not involving anything to do with undermining the state or rebellion or what have you. It wasn't a treason offense. The guy just left, which many classical Islamic scholars have said that a person who leaves Islam, they can just exile and leave an Islamic country or state, and they can go wherever they want and so on. That's actually the truth of this issue. It's a very detailed topic, and I can't respond to what Jason will say after what I speak, but in another discussion maybe I can actually elaborate on that topic. Thanks.